The 10 principles for schools of modern learning is something that we put together based on our observations of schools from around the world. It's kind of a synthesis of the things that people are doing that elevate them to kind of a different plane when it comes to thinking about schooling differently. The first one is that they have a very clear and coherent belief system around learning. They've had the conversations as a school culture, a school community, and they've articulated what they believe learning is, and they've shared that. And they really use that, those principles or that belief system to make just about every decision that they make. So they're purchasing a piece of technology, does it comport to their beliefs, and people that they hire, all of those different things. Schools have very clear mission and vision statements that are built on a real deep understanding of how the world operates today, rather than how it operated, you know, the last couple of hundred years. And I think that there's no question the world is changing very quickly, and most schools have not really kept up with those changes. So we do see schools that are constantly learning, constantly engaged in trying to understand what those changes look like and the implications of those changes for kids and for education. And then just some of the others, certainly they have a learning context for technology that most schools that we see really use technology as a teaching tool. But in the really powerful schools, they are devices that allow kids more agency and choice to pursue things at a depth that they want to pursue them. And so kids create some amazing things with technology. They connect with other people around the world. They go far beyond what's possible without the technology. And in, again, most schools, that doesn't happen. In most schools, you could take the technology away and not much would change. It would just be back to paper type of thing. And then schools that have cultures of learning, schools that are doing a great job of building the capacity of people in the community to understand what change looks like, because they're constantly sharing a different picture of what schools could be and what learning looks like in classrooms. Schools that are inviting community in on a regular basis, that in different ways to participate in what happens in classrooms, or even to do adult learning or whatever else. It becomes more of a community space. And then just a sense that they operate under a sense that things are going to perpetually be changing. So they're never done with their conversations. They're never done going back to those principles of learning. They're never done evaluating their mission and their vision. They're never done, you know, looking at the technology, all those things. It's just this, there's a phrase by a Canadian blogger that we have a perpetual beta, and that that's the way we have to operate in today's world, since it's changing so much and since there's so much uncertainty. Well, I think the biggest adaptation that schools have to go through is the idea of making the emphasis of the work on developing kids as learners, and not so much on carrying a whole bunch of content knowledge around in their heads. Again, the reality of it is most of that information stuff is pretty easily accessible now through the devices that we have, and it's going to continue to be so. That's not to say we don't need any content knowledge, but I don't think that, I think we spend a lot of time in schools making kids memorize things or prep them for tests that are measuring their ability to remember stuff. And I don't think that's a good use of our time these days, to be honest. So what I see in schools, what we see is are places where it really is about giving kids more freedom and more choice to pursue things that matter to them at depth, and then making the emphasis of our work helping them to do that really well. Because I don't think there's any doubt in the world moving forward, if it's as uncertain and fast-changing as people say it is, that the only way to navigate it is to be continually learning, and to be doing that in, a very literate sense, but also in a very connected way, and being able to manage all of that and self-determine that. So the more we give kids opportunities to pursue those things, to have choice, real choice, around what they're learning, I think the better. So, well, I think parents need to keep reading, keep thinking, keep talking, keep learning about the world. Every day in the newspaper, or you know, somewhere on news, or somewhere online from some reputable source, comes another story that says, the world is changing really quickly, it's much more uncertain, the only way that you're going to really navigate it is to be a learner, to be willing to go from job to job to job, to self-determine that, to train yourself I think, you know, when you have access to so much information, so many people, so many technologies, there's less inclination on the part of businesses or corporations or whomever else to retrain you. They just expect you to go do that because you have access to all that. So it's much more about skills and literacies and dispositions today in terms of becoming more successful. And I think you can read that into every single day, some story somewhere about how the job market is changing, how higher ed is beginning to shift. Again, the big complex problems that we have coming our way, and just the uncertainty of knowing what readiness is. We don't know. There is no readiness anymore, right? You have to be kind of ready for anything. And the more that parents can at least continue to think about those things, I think they'll build their ability to see the world a little bit differently. Doesn't necessarily mean that they'll pull their kids off a particular path, but if you talk to a lot of kids, you'll hear from them that they wish there were options. You know, they wish that there were different ways of thinking about how to go through this whole thing we call school. And there are, so we need to present those options to kids and be more comfortable with doing that, because again, that's the way the world is kind of hewing right now.